Then we had the scholars and the Salaf after that. Look at the likes of Imam Bukhari. How many volumes of hadith did he compile? And he was a young person when he started. He was only 25 years old. And then he compiled the authentic hadith into one book. And this was inspired. Imam Bukhari was sitting with his scholar, his sheikh. And they were studying hadith. Because even before Bukhari, people were studying hadith. But what Bukhari did wasn't something too new. Rather, he compiled all of the authentic hadith into one book so that it's easier for us Muslims to study the authentic hadith. So his teacher said, if only there will be someone that can compile all the authentic hadith for us into one book. If only there could be that man. He was just daydreaming. He wasn't expecting someone would do it. That stuck with Imam Bukhari. That stayed with him. He said, I'm going to be that person. And no one around him would do such a thing, because that means traveling to so many different countries, meeting people who are old now, you know, people who studied under the Sahaba, who are probably, I don't know where they live, I don't know how to reach out to them. They're quite old in their age, to go through this process and not just collect hadith. Collect the authentic hadith. His conditions were very hard. So his project was a big achievement, big legacy. How did it come? Through a vision. Our scholars of Islam, due to vision, they would travel from one city to another and they would write books on the way. They would make use of their time.